students of standard 6, we have started to discuss about the components of food. In our previous lecture, I described the substances essential for maintaining life and for growth is called a nutrient. So the components are called nutrient, and I described that there are 5 major nutrients that are carbohydrate, fats, proteins, vitamins and minerals. How are they important in our life and how they are the constituents of our balanced diet? What are their functions in our body, and what is their role in our body? So in this class I have to discuss, and you have to understood the carbohydrate, fats, proteins, vitamins and mineral and their role and their functions. So first start with the carbohydrate. They are called energy giving food, and they provide energy to our body like starch, and it comes from cereals like wheat and rice. Sources of carbohydrate are wheat, potatoes, mango, sugar and honey. All of us know that the carbohydrate are the energy giving, and we require carbohydrate in our balanced diet, and carbohydrate is a major part of our food. So the next is fats. So fats are also providing us energy. You can see the fats provide us twice as much energy as that provided by the same amount of carbohydrates. So you can say the fats are energy giving food, richest source of energy, and fats are solid at room temperature, whereas oil are liquids at room temperature, because all of us know oil is also a kind of fat. So children, you have to understood that you have to understand that the fat from plants, we get fat from plants, and we get fat from animals too. So can you name the fat from plants? All kinds of oil, children, all kinds of oil that we get from the plant, like coconut oil, sunflower oil, are fat from plants. And egg, yolk, milk, ghee, all kinds of you can say the type of milk, ghee, yolk, egg are fat from animals. Now, the carbohydrate and fat are energy-giving substances and components and nutrients. Now, you have to understand about the bodybuilding food that is called proteins. Proteins are needed for the growth and repair of our body. What does repair mean in our body? All of us know there are worn-out tissues, and when our organs become old, it requires some kinds of repair. Our proteins and the intake of protein is necessary for the repair of our body. Intake of proteins is necessary for the growing children, because they are the body building foods. So protein, here also we should know the protein as a food from the plants and from the animals. So plant proteins are pulses, soya bean and beans. All of us know that the soya bean, pulses, beans are leguminous plants that are giving, that are very rich source of protein, because we studied many times that there are nitrogenous bacteria that fix nitrogen for these plants, and their root nodules contain rhizobium bacteria that fixes nitrogen, and that really give these plants nitrogen supplement to for their growth, and soya bean and beans and pulses are a source of protein from plants. But animal proteins are milk, fish, egg, meat and chicken. Most of the food contain more than one nutrient, children, like rice, but we can see the rice is a carbohydrate rich food, and the milk and you can say egg, that is protein rich food. And after discussion of carbohydrate, fat, protein, now we have to discuss about vitamins, that is protecting our body against diseases. Our body needs all these vitamins in small quantities. So vitamins are of many types. Vitamin A, that is necessary for good eyesight, healthy skin and hair. And vitamin A sources are carrot, milk. And vitamin B1, this is essential for growth and proper functioning of the digestive system, heart, nerves and muscles. And vitamin B1 is found in yeast and cereals. And vitamin C, that are necessary for keeping teeth and gums and joints healthy. It increases our resistance of our body to infection and helps to fight against diseases. And their sources are citrus fruits like lemon, oranges, and vitamin D, that is necessary for the normal growth of bones and teeth. It helps our body to absorb calcium. What does calcium do? Calcium is a mineral, and this calcium makes the bones and teeth hard and strong. So the vitamin D is necessary for the absorption of calcium in our body, and its sources are milk, fish and egg. And minerals, although our body needs minerals for its proper functioning, normal growth and good health, minerals are calcium, phosphorus, iron, iodine, sodium and potassium. Like calcium, phosphorus is also needed for the formation of bones and teeth, and its sources are banana and pulses. Iodine is also a mineral. All of us know that the iodine is essential for the proper functioning of the thyroid gland. Children, you know there is a thyroid gland, that is an endocrine gland which controls the growth of the body. So what does the iodine do for the thyroid gland? Iodine helps thyroid gland to make a hormone which controls growth, that is thyroxine, and its sources are all the seafood and fruits. Iron is the next mineral that is required by our body because it is present in hemoglobin, which carries oxygen from the lungs to the body parts. Children, all of you know that the oxygen is inhaled by our lungs breathes oxygen, but it has to reach to each and every cell of our body for the oxidation of food to give us energy. So oxygen is carried by hemoglobin. It is an important constituent of hemoglobin in the body. Its sources are spinach and apples. So children, we discussed about the carbohydrate, fat, protein, vitamins, the type of vitamins and minerals and type of minerals and what are their functions in our body, why we require these things as the balanced food. Now, my next class, I will discuss about the water and roughage and their function inside our body. Before that, I want to give you assignment. Draw two roots and two stems that we eat.